engineering coming up, and it is a scary film because I managed to get some inside information about the tests that you didn't know about that went wrong. And where do you see what they created? And this will be the first time anyone has seen this information. We have a lot that we're doing on socially relevant issues. I'm doing it now because I believe that we're at a critical point of a perfect storm. With the collapse of our economy, with more people sick than ever before, more obesity, more diabetes, more heart disease, with the wars on cancer and drugs and AIDS and everything being complete and total failures, when we are manipulated by a political system that has betrayed us, and virtually every major institution has lied to us, they've manipulated us, they've taken our innocence, our honesty, and our trust, and they've used it against us. And for those who have awakened and no longer choose to be manipulated, now we are joining together in common cause, setting aside political differences. That's the old paradigm. That's why we couldn't have done this 10 years ago or 5 years ago, because everybody would have had to have a committee to decide which direction we were going to go before you did anything. The progressive mind says, let's just do it. All right, if there's a wrong, let's correct it, let's challenge us, educate people. And every day, there are more and more people who are awakening to the fact that their leaders, their opinion leaders, Bill O'Reilly's and Sean Hannity's, that these people are not bearers of truth. So they're looking for the truth. Now we have people outside here who have tables. Those people, you should look at what they're doing, because every day they're out there fighting on our behalf. We're going to have a panel, and starting in about 20 minutes, Dr. Bandanashita is here, all the panelists are here. We have people from Fukushima here. We have Ralph Nader of Japan here. You're going to get some insights you did not know anything about. We've saved, instead of going to press release, and I was saying, a big firm called us, a major firm. Oh, we're going to help you. You know, vice president of our firm believes this. I said, hey, so you're kidding, aren't you? Do you really think the American media is going to touch this issue and be objective about it? Not at all. We don't need the American media. They're so past their expiration date. Reporters, the resources but not the will. So the New York Times, you will not see them here and reporting honestly on the story, because they've never reported on any essential story that would have challenged the status quo. They're the ones in their paper, like Jane Brody, that allowed the Quackbusters to have an open forum to attack supplements and health food. Anything that was healthy, they found someone willing to attack, and we have always been on the defensive. Isn't it amazing? Go back the last 30 years. Many of you in this room are activists. For 30 years, look at all the major issues. When we said synthetic hormone replacement therapy was dangerous and increased women's risk of breast cancer, ovarian cancer, heart attack, stroke, and dementia, we were right, they were wrong. Who were they, on which side were they on? The side of wrong. When we said that pesticides could cause mutagenic effects, we were right, they were wrong. When we said that cell phones emit a pulse that can overheat chromosomes in the brain and hurt your brain and cause cancer, we were right, they were wrong. When we said that there's going to be a tipping point, we were right, they were wrong. When we said global warming is caused by humans and the Industrial Revolution and the effects are now going to manifest and beyond our control, the man who was the Jeff Goldblum character in Jurassic Park, there's a real man who's the chaos theorist, I filmed him. You'll see him in our 12 tipping points. It's another film I'm doing on the environment. And I said, weren't you one of the 1,200 leading scientists, climatologists, who said that the Larsen B shelf that is butting up against Antarctica would take anywhere from 100 to 5,000 years before it would break off? He said, yes. Didn't it break off 29 days later? He said, yes. I said, then how can you call yourself an expert? He says, we're not. There's no longer anything you can rely upon when it comes to environmental science. This is what he said. It's on the record. I'm going to have my film. I said, be clear with me. He said, there are no experts any longer anywhere on the planet when it comes to telling you the truth, because we don't know the truth. It's beyond us. It is quantitatively going forward, exponentially expanding. When you get into chaos theory, you can't control it. There's no due date. It's not 100 years from now when the oceans rise 6 feet. It could be in 2 years. Within 2 years, you will see major catastrophic events happen. Major. Not the least of which will happen in the next 12 to 18 months, which is the solar flares. Are we prepared? No. Are we prepared for any disaster? Any disaster? No. And if you now can take a look at how we've handled these last disasters, tornadoes, hurricanes, earthquakes, Fukushima, how have we been prepared? Then why have we spent hundreds of billions of dollars to so-called experts when all they've done is given us the promise that we can be certain that we will be safe, and we are not? That's why we're doing this. And we're doing it together. So when you leave here tonight, please pass it on. The New York Times will not talk about you and what you know, but they can't prevent you from telling someone else what you know. And pass it on to people willing to do something about it. Tomorrow I'm going to ask everyone to call Governor Cuomo and tell him no more nukes, no more nuclear power plant, close down Indian Point. We have the science. Harvey Wasserman will be there on a panel to show why there is no science on their side, but the science is on our side. So we are now going to take the battle to them. You know, have you noticed over the last 30 years, virtually every major health and environmental issue, we have been attacked and we have been condemned, we have been excluded from legitimacy, we have been made into heretics, yet we have been right on every single point, and they have never been right once. The New York Times has never been right. They've never been on the side of history, on truth. Maybe I'm just dumber than normal. Maybe they were against the war in Iraq and Judith Miller and they fired her for it. No, they didn't. And she's perfect where she's at now, Fox News. Fox must have a hiring department that has overloaded septic systems to bring that shit right in. So self-righteous that they know the truth of everything, and you don't see them getting arrested, you don't see them in demonstrations, you don't see them doing the scholarship, you don't see them doing what many of you have done, doing your homework before you force an opinion out. You're educating yourself, then you share that opinion. So what we're going to do now, we're going to take a little standing restroom break, we're going to commence again in 15 minutes.